Hello everyone, welcome to today's class of engineering physics. So in this class, first we'll start with free oscillation. So what we have learned in the previous class, that in the case of ideal simple harmonic motion, the displacement follows sinusoidal curve, and we have derived the other solutions of simple harmonic motion, that is in terms of cos and exponential form as well. So here we will take the representation of sinusoidal curve itself and explain what is free oscillation. So the ideal simple harmonic equation y is equal to a sin omega t plus phi. So I have already explained this equation. What we say in the case of free oscillation, if other than the restoring force, if any other force is not acting the system, means it is free of the frictional force, means it is free of the frictional force or any kind of resistive force, then the amplitude of oscillation will remain constant for an infinite time, as there will be no loss in the energy of the system, and hence the total energy of the system remains constant. So when the total energy remains constant and the amplitude of the oscillation remains constant for the infinite time of oscillation, then such oscillation we call it as free oscillation. And if we draw the wave the amplitude of the oscillation remain constant for the infinite time. Now if we take an example, we have already understood in the case of oscillating pendulum, the spring mass system, oscillation of spring mass system and there are many other examples of free oscillation. The only case is that other than the restoring force, what it acts on the system to make it oscillate, any other resistive force is not acting on the system, and hence the system will undergo free oscillation. So taking the example of simple pendulum, what we understand that if any force is not acting on the system, any resistive force is not acting on the system, then it oscillates freely with its own natural frequency given by 1 by 2 pi square root of g by L, where L is the length of the pendulum. And g is acceleration due to gravity. So what we understand here, if it is said to oscillate freely, the frequency of oscillation is 1 by 2 pi square root of g by L. And the time period of oscillation, reciprocal of the frequency, 2 pi square root of L by G. So the frequency with which it oscillates freely, we call it as natural frequency. So the frequency with which the pendulum or any body oscillates freely, that frequency we call it as natural frequency of oscillation or the natural frequency of vibration. So here you have to understand that in the case of simple harmonic motion, where the oscillation is free, then in this case the only force which will act on the system is the restoring force, which helps the system to oscillate freely. Now coming to the damped oscillation. So the definition of damped harmonic oscillation can be given as the oscillation in which the amplitude of oscillating system decreases and fades out after some time. So this oscillation fades out or dies out due to frictional resistance to the motion of the system. So if I take the example of a simple pendulum, which is free to oscillate under the action of the restoring force. But if we suspend the oscillating system, means this pendulum, in air or water or any other system, after certain interval of time, the pendulum stops oscillating. So in another words, if I say that it is the type of motion executed by the body under the combined action of the restoring and the resistive force. The resistive force tries to stop the oscillation of the oscillating body. So this motion will get terminated with the body coming to rest at equilibrium position in a finite interval of time. If I explain in terms of graphical representation, what we observe, so the body first oscillates with the maximum amplitude, and due to the resistive force, the amplitude decreases and the body comes finally to rest, means at mean position. So in the example we saw that if the pendulum is suspended in the air and the pendulum when it is suspended in water, an additional force acts on the pendulum which tries to fade the amplitude of the oscillation, and ultimately the body comes to the rest at its mean position. So if we compare that air and water, the oscillation stops within the less interval of time in water compared to air, as water give more resistance compared to air to the oscillating pendulum. So the other example also can be taken. You can take an example of a swing. What we observe, if we don't apply the external force, the swing comes to rest after a certain interval of time. Let us understand with the help of a figure. The body is oscillating around its mean position, and if it is a free oscillation, then the only force which is acting on the system is the restoring force. So let us understand with the help of figure. If a body is under oscillation, it oscillates under the action of the restoring force, and a resisting force to this. Suppose a block is oscillating across the mean position, then the additional force which is trying to stop it to oscillate, it also works opposite to the displacement of the body, and this force we call it as resistive force, we call it as frictional force, or we can call it as retarding force. So while deriving the differential equation of simple harmonic motion, we have to consider those two forces, that is the force, the restoring force proportional to the displacement y given by minus ky, as we have already learned in the earlier case of while deriving simple harmonic motion, and k is spring constant, and this negative sign suggests that the restoring force is working in the direction opposite to the displacement of the body. So second force is a frictional force, we also call it as retarding or resistive force, that is proportional to the velocity, and it is given by minus r dy by dt, where r is the proportionality constant, we call it as damping constant, we call it as resistive constant as well, and the negative sign suggests that both the displacement and the frictional force is in the opposite direction. Let us understand with the help of figure. If the body is oscillating across the mean position and it undergoes the displacement y, then the restoring force acts in the direction opposite to the displacement, and the resistive force also acts in the direction opposite to the displacement, and hence the body stops oscillating after the certain interval of time. So let us derive the differential equation of damped harmonic motion. So for this again we will consider a body or a system which has mass m, we represent the velocity by dy by dt, rate of change of displacement with respect to time, and the acceleration is d2y by dt square. So as per the Newton's second law of motion, m d2y by dt square is equal to minus ky, and the other resistive force also acts in the direction of the displacement, so minus r dy by dt. So the two forces are the restoring force and the resistive or the frictional force, both are acting in the direction opposite to the displacement of the oscillating system. Now let us solve further this equation. We get brought the two terms to the left hand side, and we get m d2y by dt square plus r into dy by dt plus ky is equal to 0. Now let's divide the above equation. Let's divide the above equation by m. So what we get, if you divide this by m, mm cancels out, and you get d2y by dt square plus R by M dy by dt plus K by M into y is equal to 0. Now let us replace this R by M and K by M by another constant. R by M we have replaced by 2b and K by M we have replaced by omega square. So where where 2b is equal to R by M and omega square is equal to K by M. So we can write b is equal to r by 2m and omega is equal to square root of k by m. So here b we call it as damping coefficient. And as usual omega is the angular frequency. What I have explained in the case of simple harmonic motion. Let us designate this by equation 2 and this equation 2 we call it as differential equation of damped harmonic motion. D to y by dt square 2b into dy by dt plus omega square y is equal to 0 is known as differential equation of damped harmonic motion. So let us solve this equation to get the equation for the displacement for the damped harmonic motion. So to solve this equation, the differential equation of the damped harmonic motion, let us consider a general solution y is equal to so let us consider a general solution y is equal to A exponential of alpha t. Now what we require dy by dt and d2y by dt square. So first we will differentiate this equation with respect to t and again differentiate the equation to get the value of d2y by dt square. Differentiating equation 3 with respect to t, we get dy by dt A alpha exponential of alpha t. So what we know, if you differentiate suppose with respect to dx, the exponential function, you can write, will get the exponential function itself. But when you differentiate the exponential function, which is suppose, and if we differentiate exponential of 2x, where 2 is a constant which is multiplied by x, then we will get 2 into exponential of 2x. If suppose it is exponential of ax, then you will get a into exponential of ax. The exponential term will be retained, and what is the constant with respect to what you are differentiating, that gets multiplied. So Here differentiating A exponential of alpha t, A is a constant, and alpha is multiplied with t with respect to what we are differentiating. So what we get, dy by dt is equal to A alpha exponential of alpha t. Let us write it as equation 4. Now let us differentiate equation 4 again with respect to t. What we get, d2y by dt square will be equal to A alpha square. Alpha will be again multiplied with alpha, and it will, you will get alpha square exponential of alpha t. Now let us substitute the value of equation 3, 4 and 5 in equation 2. d2y by dt square is A alpha square exponential of alpha t, then 2b, dy by dt is A alpha exponential of alpha t, and then omega square. And what we have considered the general solution, A exponential of alpha t, and this will be equal to 0. So here what we see, A exponential of alpha t is common, A exponential of alpha t is common. So we get alpha square plus 2b alpha plus omega square is equal to 0. Now in this equation, A exponential of alpha t cannot be equal to 0. If we substitute 0, then whole equation will become 0 and the body will be in non-oscillating condition. So this value, it cannot be 0. So what we can take, alpha square plus 2b alpha plus omega square is equal to 0. And you, as we see this equation, quadratic nature. Equation 7 is quadratic in nature. You have studied the quadratic equation and its roots. So what is the, in here what will be the roots of this equation? We have to find it out. So what will be the value of alpha? What we know, if we consider the general quadratic equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, if we compare these two equations, what we can see, A is equal to 1, B is equal to 2B and C is equal to omega square. And we know that this particular equation, the solution means the roots are given as minus b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Let us write the solution for this equation 7, means alpha square plus 2b alpha plus omega square, in its square root form. So in the square root form, the alpha value will be minus 2b plus minus square root of 2b square minus 4, a value is 1, c is omega square, by 2 into a, and a is 1. The equations are given by x minus b plus minus given. X is equal to minus b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. We have written alpha is equal to, what is the b value? It is 2b. So, minus 2b square root of b square means 2b whole square minus 4ac, a is here 1 and c is omega square. So, 4 into 1 into omega square and divide by 2a and a is 1, so 2 into 1. So, further solving this equation, what we get? Alpha is equal to minus 2b plus minus 4b square minus 4 omega square by 2. Now, here what we see, that 4 is common and square root of 4 it will be equal to 2. So, we get the equation 2b plus minus 2 into square root of b square minus omega square by 2. Taking 2 common, it will get cancelled out with the denominator 2. So, finally, we can write alpha is equal to minus b plus minus square root of b square minus omega square. So, what we observe here, that if we take this equation alpha square 2b alpha plus omega square, which is quadratic in equation, we have not one solution for the differential equation of motion in terms of alpha. We have two values. What we can say, alpha 1 is equal to minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square, and alpha 2 is equal to minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square. So, what we took general equation, y is equal to a exponential of alpha t. This alpha has two solutions. So, what we can write, that y is equal to a exponential of alpha 1 into t plus b exponential of alpha 2 into t. Let us write it as equation number 8. So, we have not one solution of alpha. What is alpha is taking two values. That is minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square, and alpha 2 is equal to minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square. So, we are getting y is equal to a exponential of alpha 1 into t plus b exponential of alpha 2 into t. Now, let us substitute the value of alpha 1 and alpha 2. So, substituting the value of alpha 1 and alpha 2 here, alpha 1 and alpha 2, what we are getting, y is equal to a exponential of minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square. This is the value of alpha 1 plus b into exponential of minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square into t, and this is what we have substituted, the value of alpha 2. So, where a and b are, so, a and b are arbitrary constants to be evaluated. What we understand by arbitrary constant, it is constant which depends on the value of other constants. Not unlike universal constant which has its own value. So this arbitrary constant we can evaluate taking the initial condition. And we will understand initial condition that the body it has extreme means at time t is equal to 0, y is equal to y naught. The amplitude of oscillation is y naught. At time t is equal to 0, and we have understood in our previous class that the extreme position, the velocity of oscillation is equal to 0, and velocity what we understand is rate of change of displacement with respect to time, and that is equal to 0. So if initial condition we take it, what we can say, at t is equal to 0, y is equal to y naught, and second, at t is equal to 0, your dy by dt is equal to 0. So first let us take the condition 1. If we take condition 1, what we understand here, t is equal to 0. So 0 multiplied by any value, it will be equal to 0. Here if we multiply 0, again t multiplied by minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square multiplied by 0, it will be equal to 0. And exponential of 0 is equal to 1. So what we get, y is equal to a, exponential of 0 is 1, plus b, and exponential of 0 it is 1, and y is equal to y naught in this condition. So here what we get, y naught is equal to a plus b, or we can say a plus b is equal to y naught. Let us designate this equation by 9 and 10. Now next we will take condition 2. So for taking condition 2, first we have to differentiate equation 9. So let us first differentiate equation 9 and then substitute the value at t is equal to 0, dy by dt is equal to 0. So differentiating y with respect to t. So differentiating a exponential of minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square into t, we get a exponential term we are differentiating. So the constant term will get multiplied first, plus square root of b square minus omega square, and the exponential term we have to retain as it is. Exponential of minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square into t. Now differentiating the second term. So b minus, here what it is, minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square, it will be multiplied. An exponential term as it is, we have to write it. So let us write it as equation number 11. Now we have to substitute dy by dt is equal to 0 at t is equal to 0. So as usual, if we put t is equal to 0, the whole term it becomes, when you multiply by minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square, it will become 0, and exponential of 0, it will be equal to 1. Similarly here, if we substitute t is equal to 0, then multiplied by this term, we get exponential of 0, and exponential of 0, it will be equal to 1. So finally what we get? 0 equals a minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square, and this term is equal to 1 as explained. Next, b into minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square. And this exponential term, because t is equal to 0, exponential of 0, it will be equal to 1. Now let us further simplify this equation. If we simplify this equation, first multiply a to the term inside the bracket and b to the term inside the bracket. What you will get? Minus b into a plus square root of b square minus omega square into a, plus minus minus b into b, and again plus minus minus, so square root of b square minus omega square into b. So we have two terms with b common, and we will have two terms with b square minus omega square common. So let us simplify using the common terms. We get 0 is equal to minus b, and if you take minus b common, you get a plus b, and next we'll take b square minus omega square common, we get a minus b. And from the previous solution, case 1, we have put the condition t is equal to 0, y is equal to y naught. We got a plus b is equal to y naught. So let us substitute this value for a plus b, that is y naught plus square root of b square minus omega square into a minus b. Now let us further simplify. Further, we are trying to find out what is the value of a minus b. So a minus b into square root of b square minus omega square, that will be equal to b y naught. We took minus b y naught to the left hand side, so it will be plus b y naught, and swap the equation. What you get? A minus b square root of b square minus omega square is equal to b y naught. So what we get finally? B y naught divide by square root of b square minus omega square, and let us write it as equation number 11. So now we have value of a minus b and a plus b. What was our aim? It was aim to evaluate the value of a and b. So what we will do first? First we will add equation 10 and 11 to get the value of a, and then we'll subtract 10 and 11 to get the value of B. So adding equation 10 and 11, A plus A, it will be 2A, and plus B minus B, it will be cancelled out. What you get? 2A is equal to Y naught plus BY naught divided by square root of B square minus omega square, or you can write A is equal to Y naught is common and dividing by 2, what we get? Y naught by 2, 1 plus B divided by square root of B square minus omega square. So now we have evaluated value of A. Now let us evaluate what will be the value of B. If I rewrite the equation, so here we have added equation 10 and 11 . Now let us subtract equation 11 from 10. So we get subtracting minus sign, it will change plus, and here plus it is front, so it will be minus. So here A minus plus A and minus A, it will be cancelled out. B plus B, it will be equal to 2B, and Y minus Y naught minus BY naught square root of B square minus omega square. So again, as usual, take Y naught common and divide this by 2, we get B is equal to Y naught by 2, 1 minus B divided by square root of B square minus omega square. Let us write it as equation 13. So we have a value of A. You have to remember both is similar equation with one A term is 1 plus B by square root of B square minus omega square, and B is with 1 minus B divided by square root of B square minus omega square. Just for remembrance, here it is plus, here it is minus. Now let us substitute this equation 12 and 13 in the previous equation. So we'll substitute value of equation 12 and 13, that is the value of A and B, in equation 9. Y is equal to A value is Y naught by 2, 1 plus B divided by square root of B square minus omega square, then exponential of minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square into t. Then the b term, it is y naught by 2 1 minus b divided by square root of b square minus omega square exponential of minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square into t. Now y1 naught by 2 is common, so we can write y is equal to y naught by 2 1 plus b divided by square root of b square minus omega square exponential of minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square into t plus 1 minus b divided by square root of b square minus omega square exponential of minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square into t. So this equation, fourteen represents the general solution of differential equation of damped harmonic motion. So in today's class we have learned about the free oscillation and its few examples, and then we have studied the definition of damped harmonic motion, and later we have derived the differential equation of damped harmonic motion, and finally we have arrived for the solution of general solution of differential equation of damped harmonic motion. And in next class we'll discuss the cases for the damped harmonic motion where we have to consider the value of b and omega. B means when b square is greater than omega square, it is the case of heavy damping. B square is equal to omega square, here whatever the term we will solve it using this equation itself. Equation 14 we will start and we will discuss the conditions, and finally the third condition where b square is less than omega square, see that whether the condition leads to harmonic motion or not. Thank you.